on purpose. But look, Andrew Luck didn't avoid him on Sunday, throwing his way 13 times. He did a nice job avoiding him on this run, though, and then Ramsey hit him with the down low too slow right there. And on the game's final play, who says Florida State corners don't tackle, right? There he is. Little controversial play there at the end, but the Jags, they got it done. They got the win after the game. Jalen let us all know it's all good between he and Luck, even though he told GQ this offseason that he doesn't think Luck is that good. He was an all-pro corner last year, one of the brightest spots on this amazing defense. But this year, Pro Football Focus says he hasn't been the same player, that teams haven't been avoiding him in coverage the same way. So why has his play dropped off this season, Willie? Do you think it has, or are we just, like, noticing when he makes those mistakes?
I don't really understand where Pro Football was looking at, but this is one of the most dangerous defensive players in the league. He has, in the last 3 weeks, been thrown at probably more than any defensive back, 31 times, and he's under 45%. So when you talk about his production, when you talk about pass defense, he's in the top at every single category. And this defense in the last 2 weeks has only given up 6 points. Now, I know when you're not playing well and you're one of those guys that were chirping and talking a lot preseason before the season started, you're going to get a lot of the attention. But make no mistake about it, Jalen Ramsey has been playing great football. The defense and team in general, no, but he is still one of the best defenders in the league.
By the way, I can't just let this go. You're still wearing your hat.
Am I? Well, is that what's
very
up there?
Excited about the cowboy hat.
I was pretty excited.
We'll get to you in a second on this, but Steve, what do you think about Jalen Ramsey?
Well, I believe that, you know, what Pro Football Focus said, he's ranked 25th, but you also understand that a lot of, just like a wide receiver, DB, the wide receiver depends on his offensive line. The secondary depends on their defensive line. But also, too, they have a lot of communication issues. This is an overthrown ball, but you've seen throughout the year with the Jags defense having communication issues, not communicating, not talking. But this young man has the ability to read coverages, shut down one side of the block to where teams are avoiding him completely. And it's not just Jalen that's his year has dropped off. It's the defense in total. Right. This defense is last year 16 points, 20 points this year. But one of the key things, though, that's really big as I look at this secondary last year, almost 3.5 sacks per game. They're only getting two sacks a game. That, for a defense that's producing as well as they did last year, that hurts a team, and it also hurts the most benefiting factor of a sack is your secondary.
Cowboy Joe, what do you think?
This is fake news. Don't buy into this hype about Jalen Ramsey not being the same player he was last year.
Yep.
Look, it's a factor of two things. One, their offense is just terrible. When your defense is forced to go out on the field over and over and over again, and the opposing offense has no fear of turning the ball over or taking a risk because they know that offense isn't very good for the Jacksonville Jaguars, so they're not going to be able to capitalize on those mistakes. And then the other thing is, when you make yourself the villain of the NFL for the fans, for other players, you're going to put yourself under a microscope. And everybody's going to watch every little mistake that you make or that people perceive that you make, because in the secondary, a lot of times you don't know whose fault it really was.
Yeah.
And they're going to give him the credit because they don't like him, because now he's the NFL villain. Right. And as a cornerback, one or two bad plays, and people are going to think that you had a bad game. It's a lot like being a left tackle, man.
No,
I give up one or two sacks in a game, people say I had a terrible game. Unlike you, 8 or 9 catches in a game, you're going to the Hall of Fame. And don't even get me started on Willie.
No, we are still over there. We're going to leave it alone.
1 sack a game, you're one of the greatest of all time. So all you have to do is
show up one time.
Me, I got to play 66 out of 66 perfect snaps, or I got to answer to the media why I had a terrible game.
I'm playing the world's smallest violin.
Thank you very much.
I thought we were
just 8 or 9 catches, and then I go to the Hall of Fame?
8 or 9 catches a week, you're in the Hall of Fame.
Man,
anyway.
Hey, watch out. Watch out, Mike Irvin. Here I come.
I should mention that Jalen Ramsey's numbers this year are pretty similar to what he had last year in terms of completion percentage and passer rating against.
Is that the kicker?
Yes, Cody Kessler, is the quarterback.
Was that the kicker?